standing until we seen him here, just to get things started. We were very fortunate to be here before the rain started, most of us. There are a few that didn't make it. By way of introduction, I am David Creek. I'm the pastor of First United Methodist Church and the secretary. And I can't remember, but this is my seventh or eighth year at Baccalaureate. And it's been such a pleasure to do this, to represent the Dorchester County Faith Alliance, representing this Baccalaureate service here at Dorchester. The Faith Alliance is the ministerial association in Dorchester County. And we do things in the schools that the schools can't do. So we're just glad to be able to do that. It's an honor to be part of this celebration today. It is a celebration. It's a celebration of worship. It's in preparation for the actual graduation. And I'm honored to be joined on the program today by my colleagues in ministry, Reverend David Talley, who you may have seen from up here with his cane. Physical fitness can be harmful to your health if you hurt his foot playing basketball or something. Reverend Brandon Pierce, Pastor Brandon Pierce. Brandon is leaving tomorrow with his family to embark on a four-year mission experience in some faraway place in the world. I don't even know where it is. He's looking forward to that, but I'm just so pleased that he's here with us today to help us celebrate. And our speaker, Mr. Kevin Lewis, he's back on Popular Man. Brand new dad, and he's still here, bless his heart. Now, many people have a vital part to play in this service. Some by virtue of their position as class officers, pardon my back, I'm sorry, young folks. Some because of their desire to be part of the musical group. Many others who have contributed so much to make this day the success that it will be. The order of the day is printed in your program. Everybody has one. If not, somebody get it for you. And introductions will be made by designated individuals as the program unfolds. We've been very blessed in the past, and it will continue today, I'm sure. It's been a very seamless transition. The introductor just gets up and introduces the person, and everything moves very smoothly. I would ask now, while we're standing, please join with us now in singing of the opening hymn, Joyful, Joyful. The words are in the program. And please enjoy your time with us this afternoon.
Willingly choose to surrender your life. Willingly allow your knees to bow. With all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, choose him gladly. Choose him now. Whatever is said or done here tonight, today and every day, may our spirits be humbled as we consider the greatness of our God, the terror of his judgment, the awfulness of his wrath, the fear that he rightfully deserves, and the fragility of our own existence. May our hearts be grateful as we look within and recognize the blessings that God has so graciously given to every one of us, and especially tonight, his kindness and generosity to the class of 2019. And may our souls be lifted as we look in wonder at the love and compassion of God, as it is seen in the face of his Son, who willingly sacrificed himself so that we might be accepted into the presence of his Holy Father. Students, graduates, educators, family, friends, neighbors, all who have gathered here at this place tonight, let us quiet our minds and reflect on the glory and power of the God who made us, and let us celebrate his mercy and grace. Amen.
Good afternoon. Welcome, family, friends, community members. Thank you to Reverend Creek, Pastor Talley, Pastor Pierce, and to the Dorchester Faith Alliance for continuing to provide the baccalaureate service for our graduates. When I speak with colleagues across the tri-state area, oftentimes they share with me that their school district no longer holds baccalaureate ceremony. We are incredibly fortunate in Dorchester County to continue this community-based faith gathering in this learning community, North Dorchester High School. For that, I say thank you. At this time, I ask Class President Jocelyn Myers to come forward, and the North Dorchester High School Baccalaureate Chorus will perform My Life is in Your Hands.
Thank you. consecrating, continuing your programs. Happy is the one who finds wisdom. For the gain of it is better than the gain from silver. She is more precious than jewels.
And nothing you desire can compare to her.
Long life is in her right hand.
In her left hand her riches is gone.
Her ways are the ways of pleasantness.
And all her paths are peace.
She is the tree of life to those who lay hold of her.
Those who hold her fast are all happy.
The Lord, by wisdom, founded the earth.
By understanding, the Lord established the heavens.
Class Vice President Jasmine Alton will now read the scripture.
Our scripture reading is from Paul's letter to the Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. Let us not become weary in doing good, for the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Our senior class secretary, Lucas Stork, will now introduce today's speaker.
Good evening. Tonight we have the opportunity to welcome Mr. Kevin Lewis as our baccalaureate speaker. He's in his sixth year of teaching, five of which were here in Dorchester County, and now he resides in Prince George's County, Maryland, teaching at Laurel High School. He was born in Washington, D.C., and raised in Capitol Heights, Maryland, as the youngest of three children born to mother, Rita Lewis. Mr. Lewis is a proud alumni of Morgan State University, where he received a Bachelor's of Arts degree in music, specifically vocal performance, as well as his Master of Arts in teaching. He led his students to much success at all levels, and he had the tremendous honor this past year of being one of the assistant directors of the Prince George's County Public Schools Honors Chorus. Mr. Lewis has been honored on multiple occasions for his service to the community and continues to work with the youth and young adults in a number of endeavors. Mr. Lewis teaches with the mantra, "Confidence has no competition," and believes that his calling in life is to save lives. In April of 2019, Mr. Lewis was blessed to welcome into the world his son, Kevin A. Lewis Jr., or better known as K2. Welcome, Mr. Lewis.
Good evening. Yes, the two of us, and I'm sure you've heard him fussing in the background, came running in right about 5 o'clock. But we're certainly glad to be here. Thank you so much. This is already irritating me. All right. I want to first extend a thank you to Sacred Stewart, who was the person who gave me the tools that I had when I first started teaching. And it was in my second year, which these were my eighth graders in my second year, that we started to see things come to fruition. So I looked at this group of kids, and I've been talking about stories about them to people for the longest time. I think of Jasmine and Kai and Kennedy, which I'm gonna tell y'all the truth because I got the mic, so they can't do anything about this. They said, "Mr. Lewis, you don't like the black students." That's what they told me. I said, "That's a very interesting observation that you have, but okay." I think what we tended to go back and forth about was that I challenged them. But this group, they like to challenge me. For instance, one Emily Marshall. Emily spent a little bit of time in a wheelchair in the eighth grade, and she thought that the wheelchair meant that her arms and hands and mind didn't work anymore. And so sometimes we had to fight in the classroom because she didn't want to do her work. But I knew that wasn't the young lady that she was going to be, and as we can see, as she's wrapped in cords, she's starting to turn out to be the person that we always knew that she could. I always told Jordan's mother that Jordan was the perfect idea to me of a student because Jordan had such a pure heart and a pure spirit, and I know that her future is going to be bright. Now then there was Abrajanan. And she, yeah, challenge is the word. But you had to love the spirit, and my favorite part about her is we have the what? the exact same birthday. Yeah, see, I remember these things. April 21st, there was no wonder why she's stubborn. She's a Taurus. Yes, Jocelyn Myers, I'm so proud of you. She's just a wonderful talent. This group was filled with wonderfully talented people, but Jocelyn was always one that I could call on to take the lead. And actually with this group, Miss Bates, actually both Bates, but one of them left me, I won't tell you which one is which, but this was the first year that we took over as the most middle school students in All Shore. And it was our first year going to the state level, but I was only able to take girls. Sorry, Seth. He wanted to sing alto, and I'm sure he could, but I wouldn't allow him to go. We went to the state level. These girls, they had so much talent. And I just think in the way that the world is moving, with women taking over, these are going to be the ones who lead in the future. And I sat back and thought about what I could say to this group. Sorry, Jasmine, about the short verse. I felt like she could have read that from her seat. But there was so much packed into this verse that I don't want you all to find frustration in doing what is the right thing. Being back in Prince George's County, which is actually home for me now, my school has 1,900 kids in the building. I'm sure that's a lot more than you're used to seeing. 1,900 kids total. And the graduation rates are not quite where we want them to be. And so at a point, these kids started together, and now some of them are going to be finishing and some of them are not. You all are in a really fortunate place that the same people you started with, you're going to be finishing with in a few days. And I don't want you to take that for granted. But then once you head out into the real world, each of you is kind of going in your own direction. Y'all got scholarships. That's a lot of money. Let me borrow a dollar. We'll talk about it later. Some of you heading into the armed services. Some of you have jobs. I stalk your parents on Facebook, so I know what's going on with you. But you are prepared to do some things that some of your peers before you didn't do, and some of your peers after you won't have the opportunity to do. But you always have to remember to do good, because the world is filled with people who do good and we don't recognize them enough. So today is a day where we get to recognize you all for all the good that you have done and will continue to do. But there's the other part of that. That's the if. You can't grow weary. You'll reap it if you don't grow weary. And it's okay to become tired sometimes, but I never want you to give up, because high school was a four-year experience for a lot of you. Some of you, you got there by grace, a little bit of mercy, and some of you sprinted across the finish line, but you made it to this point in time, and that's the reason all these people here are gathered to celebrate you. But you're going to meet some real challenges out there, regardless of where your path is taking you. And you're going to discover that there are some people you work with. I'm sure you hear your parents fuss about their coworkers. None of them here. If your coworkers are here, it's not about them. But you'll experience some people who may want to take you out of your character. You have to remember who you are at the end of the day, because the religious service will tell you, you are a child of God. And because you are a child of God, God is going to keep you in whatever walk of life you all choose to take. And it's okay to make mistakes, but you have to learn from those mistakes. God is a forgiving God, he's a loving God, and he's a God that gives us grace and mercy. So we hold on to these things. I often think about my struggle in undergrad, and it was a struggle. Okay, 5.5 years, I still got out. Whatever, it's not about me today. But I had to learn some things along the way. I had to repeat a couple courses. Don't worry, I did better in grad school. I taught them pretty well, it turned out okay. But I had to learn some things along the way, and there were a lot of my peers who I started with in the fall of 2000, who did not finish with me. And so I had to think about what made me different than some of the other ones. I held on to the things that God told me I had inside of me. I had strength inside of me, I had courage, I was wise, I was talented. If I did not embrace those things that God gave me as gifts, I would not have seen that finish line. And so then after that, I made my way to grad school. I was a 4.0 student there, because you can't fail any courses in grad school, it's a different beast. I'm trying to give you guys some tips right now, okay? But it was a different experience, and still, some people in graduate school started with me and didn't finish. You can't give up on your goals and your dreams. Even sometimes, parents, I love you, it's not about y'all today. Sometimes your parents aren't going to agree with what your dreams are, But when God gives you a vision, it's for you and you alone. And so you have to hold on to that vision. That may not even be for you to share with anybody until it actually comes to fruition, because people, they care about you. So they'll ask you, can you handle it? Are you ready to do this? That kind of thing. But when God places a vision in your mind and in your heart, it's for you to get done, and He'll see you through the entire way. So hold on to that vision. Don't let anybody talk you out of it. And I love my mother to death. I'm talking to y'all from personal experience. When I told her I wanted to be a music teacher, she said, music teachers don't make any money. She said, teachers don't make any money. That's actually still true. But she said, you know, when they cut budgets, the arts are the first to go. And I told her, God's got me. And I've never wanted for any work from the moment I crossed the stage and received my degrees. Even when I didn't have all of the necessary credits and things, test passed, God still sustained me in my career. And so it's because I chose to take that leap of faith and trust Him in the process that it kept me along the way. And so that vision is yours, and there are going to be times where you get frustrated, and there are going to be times where you're tired, times where you want to give up. But the God who got you to this point is going to take you to an even further place that some of us may not see for you, but it's for you. It's for you. God doesn't want you to be weary. It's okay, because you call on Him for strength. But do not give up on your goals and your dreams. You all are the class of 2019, a bright set of students that I've seen that from you since the seventh grade. Y'all probably don't get on my nerves as much now as you did in the seventh grade, but I've always seen that potential in you that's coming to fruition today. So I drove 2 hours with a screaming child to tell you that you all are about to do some wonderful things if you hold on to God's unchanging hand. So I wish you the best. I'm sure your parents are smiling and beaming and grinning about you all from ear to ear, and we can't wait to see what the other side has for you. Get weary, be tired, but don't give up. God bless you all.
That they may continue to excel in leadership, scholarship, and service. That they may come alive to lives of fulfillment and joy, and that they may prosper and flourish in their vocations. We pray for the parents, families, and friends of our graduates. We give praise for their perseverance and dedication. We pray for the faculty, staff, and administrators who have guided this class of graduates throughout their years of study. We give thanks for their leadership, scholarship, teaching, and service. We give praise for their graceful presence and compassionate shepherding. We ask you to inspire our hearts and minds to pursue and attain to even greater knowledge and insight. That the ordering of our society and its affairs might be improved, that justice and mercy might prevail, and that your glory may be known upon the earth. In all of these things, we will fulfill your command, O God, and so we offer you all the praise and glory of this day. Amen. And now, Pastor Brandon Pierce will bring our benediction.
Thank you, Jocelyn. For our benediction, I'm also gonna pray a blessing over our graduates. We're going to thank God for all that He's done in their lives so far. We're going to rejoice over what He's done, and we're going to ask God's blessing from this day on. Will you all please join me in praying? And I want to do something that symbolically represents us laying hands on them and joining them in their life journey and supporting them on this important day. Will you all just stretch out your hands as we pray together over our graduates? Jocelyn asked some bold things for her class. We want to continue to pray those bold things over you guys for years to come. So let's pray together. We thank you, God of all ages, for you have been a dwelling place for us from one generation to the next. Today we rejoice in the good works that you have begun in our graduates. We trust that you will see this work to completion in the ages to come. And so we ask this blessing upon these graduates. May the God of all creation, who numbered our days before a single one came to be, bless each one of you and prosper you from strength to greater strength in him. May the God of all wisdom, who sent holy prophets to guide and teach us, inspire you to act with integrity, seek the truth in love, and pursue justice for all people. May the God of infinite compassion, whose love is brought to perfection in us, when we stir one another, stir your hearts to seek the common good, compel you to forgive your enemies and friends alike, and make you extravagant in your generosity to others. May the God of all salvation, the one who is slow to anger and abounding in mercy, keep you far from evil, rescue you from harm, and restore you to wholeness when trouble comes your way. May the God of all understanding give meaning and purpose to your work, bring joy and new life to the people you meet, provide wisdom to discern what is right, and courage to follow God's will for your life. May the peace of God that transcends all understanding guard your hearts and minds, calm your fears, relieve your doubts, and sustain you with hope. And may God's blessing be upon each of you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen.